Eagle Houston, after yaw around, angles, S-band pitch, minus 9er, yaw, plus 1-8.
Four forward, drift into the right level. Okay. Contact light. Okay, engine stop.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
The dawn of aviation, and Purdue University was there, leading the way with the people, technology, and innovation to follow a dream.
Purdue was already doing research and transportation with locomotives. And when powered flight began, President Elliott had the idea that, you know, this thing might just take off. And so there were programs in mechanical engineering and then other programs that evolved into our department, all of which came about from that early heritage of doing transportation research. We were the first at Purdue to offer an aviation degree. Purdue was the first university in the country to own and operate its own airport. And Purdue University was the first to offer the civilian pilot training program prior to World War II. Purdue professors literally wrote the book on airplane design and offered courses in aeronautical engineering as early as 1921.
And from this vantage point in aviation technology and aeronautics, Purdue was poised to lead us into the space age.
We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills.
Purdue University responded to that clarion call with the science and technology our nation needed to win the space race. Our researchers and educators nurtured and developed the emerging science of astronautics, instituting an effective and far-reaching program that has taken us beyond the bounds of our own planet and opened the doors to the heavens. A program that has earned global recognition for Purdue University as the cradle of astronauts.
More than a third of all U.S. space missions have involved Purdue graduates as crew members. Neil Armstrong, the first man on the moon, and Gene Cernan, the most recent man on the moon, are Purdue graduates as well. They join 20 other Purdue graduates who have been chosen for spaceflight. You may not know that Purdue University and MIT have graduated more men and women who have flown in space than any other non-military university in the world. When you consider the contributions of the 7,000 alumni of the school, there's not a plane or a spacecraft that hasn't been touched by Purdue.
Purdue was the obvious choice. It's known as the cradle of astronauts and also has a very strong relationship with the co-op program at the Johnson Space Center, which I'm currently a part of, and that was one of my goals. And my parents are both alumni, so it was a very obvious choice to come to Purdue.
I decided to attend Purdue University because it was one of the engineering schools I looked at, and after I visited, I fell in love, and it was definitely a school I wanted to go to. Well, I've planned to go to grad school and onward to my PhD. I plan to, hopefully, I will be able to become an astronaut. I would love to try and go there.
When I found out about Purdue, I found out more that it was a lot of astronauts came from Purdue, and I figured I might as well head that way because it worked for them, and why wouldn't it work for me? In the future, I hope to be like Neil because he was a good role model, but kind of hope to maybe trump him a little bit and be the first person on another planet rather than just the moon.